A woman refused to give up her seat on a plane for a mom who wanted to sit next to her two kids. And it's taken TikTok by storm. Everyone's very divided. The woman in question is Tammy Nelson. She's the CEO of a jewelry brand who shared this. Here's this graphic on TikTok. What would you do? I got on the plane and a woman was sitting in my seat. And when I mentioned it to her, she said, oh, you want to sit here? I thought we could switch because these are my kids. She points to the two seats next to mine. I said, as long as it's a window seat, I'm happy to switch. She points to the row behind us and says, mine's right there. It's the middle seat. Dun, dun, dun. So she asks, what would you do? It seems like she didn't give up her seat, but we'll get to that. She says, this is according to Newsweek, because this is newsworthy, I guess. I double checked my boarding pass thinking I might have had the wrong row. When I confirmed I was looking at the correct seat, I thought she must have just mistakenly sat in the wrong seat. So I said, I'm sorry, but it seems like you're in my seat, thinking she would realize and move. But then, as I just explained, she sort of gave the whole like, can we just swap skis? There's my middle seat. Tammy continues and says, look, I get motion sickness during takeoff and landing. If I can't see out the window, I also don't get a lot of sleep. So I often try to sleep on planes, which is easiest with a window seat, except if you're in that weird gap. I hate that when it's like, oh no, the pillars don't line up right.
I hate it.
She says, on that particular day, I only had 90 minutes of sleep the night before, and I was headed to a high pressure work week that we'd be presenting 500 people, and I really needed to be at my very best. So she's over and over and over again. By the way, very important before I kick it to you guys, how old were the kids? How heartless was this woman to not give up her seat or to not agree to switch? The kids were about 11 and 15, according to Tammy, and the mom was within arm's reach of both of them from the middle seat in the row behind us, you know, sort of slapping distance. The mom proceeded to complain for at least 15 minutes to the person next to her, loud enough for me to hear, but the woman actually defended me several times, I guess the person she complained to. It was so kind and I appreciated it so much because I was feeling really guilty. There's some comments, but you guys, should she feel guilty for not giving up her window seat for a middle seat?
Yeah, I've got some comments and they're pretty definitive. I'm curious what you all think, but I'm also curious what you guys think. So we're doing a poll, tyt.com/polls.
Be careful.
Was the CEO in the wrong here for refusing to switch seats with a mother behind her? So we'll also have a link in the description box. You just click it. Okay, so look, to me, there's a couple of factors here. The age of the kids, definitely relevant. The length of the flight, definitely relevant.
Yeah.
And so if you're coming to me with this nonsense of the 11 and the 15-year-old kid, not gonna happen, brother. Okay, so your sister, it doesn't matter. Your 15-year-old needs to be comfortable, so I'm gonna take a middle seat for 6 hours. Again, hell dot no dot. Okay, no, not even close. And I don't know why the fact that she's a CEO is in the story. What are we supposed to hate her because she's a CEO? Yeah. She doesn't want to sit in the middle. Like, who wants to sit in the middle? Is that a thing, right? So, and guys, I have personal experience with this because I just took an international flight last year, actually, and my kids were 9 and 11, and we wound up, it was just a mess, and we wound up in four completely different seats in completely different parts of the plane. And it's an international, it's like 10, 11, 12 hours. Like, it's a disaster of a flight, okay? And I went and tried to switch seats so I can get close to the kids, right? As Francesca brilliantly put it, within slapping distance. okay, we don't do that. Anyways.
No, oh, of course not.
But I didn't have the temerity to ask anyone to move to a middle seat. That no, you cannot do that. That's way outside the bounds of etiquette. And then look, if somebody asked me and they had young kids, and it's a short flight for I'm in LA to Vegas to San Francisco, an hour and a half, 2 hours, 3 hours, and the kids are really young. Okay, I could live with it, right? Cross country, your kid's 15 years old. Hell no. No way.
It's okay. First of all, it started with the expectation that, oh, I figured I could sit here. Cool.
Yeah.
You can like to sit there, but the expectation that whoever this is that you never met before and whatever circumstances she's got don't matter is the hardest part here. You can ask, you can be like, I was wondering, I was hoping. I would have stood next to the row of seats and be like, I'm just waiting for the person, or maybe I'd stand in the seat and be like, oh, you're here. I was seeing if you could switch with me. You can even start there. I gotta be honest, I wouldn't even have asked, because we know the answer. There's a reason why that people don't choose the middle seat. It's like people know this. Come on, calm down. But again, I'm glad you made the CEO comment, because yeah, sure, every time you may see or read that there's a CEO involved, you go, we're starting off bad, which maybe you have a pretty good indication that you are. Who knows? But that doesn't have anything to do with an airplane seat. She still has to work. She still slept only 90 minutes. Whatever circumstances those were, don't matter to you. By the way, you got 11, 15-year-old. Again, this is according to the CEO, that those kids are that age. So we're going off of that. There's other options here. You've got a middle seat. You've got a middle seat that's behind your two children. And this one wants to sit in the window seat. You know what you could do? Put your 15-year-old in the middle seat behind you.
Yes.
And then you sit with your 11-year-old.
Yes.
Cool, right? Yeah. It kind of works. And then this lady has her seat. She naps, she snores. Your 15-year-old is fine. Actually, your 15-year-old might be happier not to sit next to you if it's the typical 15-year-old that it just might be. But this expectation is the hardest part here. Just maybe have some different approach, and you might actually put enough sugar on this question that the person might go, oh, this person's actually trying to look out for both of us, rather than the expectation that I just automatically give up my seat simply because of that fact. Now, I also understand, because some people that were mad at this lady who expected the seat to be given up, they were like, well, you should plan better, have all three together. Sometimes that is tough. And sometimes maybe people don't have the extra money to then pay for those upgrades for these seats all next to each other. Fine, I know that's a personal problem and it's not yours, but that's at least, I think that's a pushback on the people that have this expectation. This woman with her two kids just should have planned better, maybe should have had the money to make that happen. Maybe she didn't. But only thing left you have is to kind of ask rather than expect. That's what I think, we got to start off on the wrong foot.
Yeah, I think that's really real. And I also think that your like problem solving of like having the kids sit in the middle row is brilliant in the middle seat. The comments were mixed. Some people said, yeah, you should book seats together next time. But obviously, you know, the CEO nabbed that window seat. You know, she did. She's got business. Mm-hmm. She's got the points. She has an assistant do it for her. But then other people are saying, put yourself in the mom's shoes. So in that sense, here's what I will say. I think it's a nice thing to do, even if it sucks. And if the lady is already there, and I'm gonna make everybody get up, and so I can go into the window seat and the whole thing, to me, that is, and the fact that she felt guilty the whole time anyway, after like, you know, refusing to do it, I'm like, no, I can't sleep at that point. You know what, no, I'll just take the middle seat and feel really good and be like, karma, karma, karma. But here's another idea, like buy her a drink or something. Be like, hey, let me get you a cocktail. They have great cocktails on American, have you heard? You know, something to ask. Here's like full disclosure, here's what I do when I wanna sit with my partner, but we also want the middle seat free. What you do is you book either side. You book the window and the aisle, not together. And then you hope that no one takes the middle seat. But if there is someone, they'll gladly switch with you for the aisle or the window, and then one of you is stuck in the middle, but you did have that 50-50 chance, or maybe even better, of getting a free middle seat, then you don't even have to touch your partner.
Francesca,
when you're
flying. I'm not sure if enough people have enough strategy when they're choosing seats, because I do it all the time. I overthink everything.
That's so, a strategy.
Yeah, also by the way, there's a positioning on the plane, you should do it. If you're gonna choose the aisle and window, hoping that no one chooses that middle, people are more likely to choose the middle if it's closer to the front. So go as far back as possible and aisle and window. Because people, if there's a hierarchy, they're like, oh shoot, there's only middle seats left. Okay, let me try and at least have one good thing here, closer to the front. Mm. If it's middle and back, oh, two strikes. So it's a better chance. I've sat my ass all the way to the back against that wall before, and be like, nobody's gonna sit back here. I'd rather not have as much of a recline rather than to then have to maybe sit with someone in the middle. Absolutely. I mean, and by the way, that lean against the window, there's nothing like it. By the way, aisle seats are way overrated. 100% overrated. Be like, I gotta get up and use the bathroom. No. How about you go ahead and pee before you get in on the plane? And hopefully you can last for the length of the flight. But sitting in the aisle seat, you know what you have to do then in the aisle seat? You definitely can't sleep, because guess who has to get up and use the bathroom? Window seat, middle seat. Window seat, middle seat.
I don't care.
Oh, I gotta stretch my legs. You gotta get your ass up every time. It's Aisle seats are way overrated.
Aisle forever. Cenk, you feel me, you were nodding.
Oh yeah. All right, look, first of all, let's admit that you guys are strategic geniuses about planes. I have not put any kind of thought that, like, this level
I love
of thought.
Flying.
Yeah, and by the way, and I take planes probably way more than both of you guys combined. Next time I'm calling you guys to do the strategery for me, as Bush would say. No, I'm with, everybody's different. I'm with Francesca, I need aisle. I gotta get up, and I hate bothering people. But I, like Ben Mankiewicz says that he would rather be hospitalized than go to the bathroom on a plane. So
true too. Yeah.
Okay, so like everybody's different. But JR hit it. It's how you ask, and if you're asking somebody to switch to a middle seat for not a good reason, you shouldn't even ask in the first place. It's super rude to even ask it. But then when you have this sense of entitlement, the only reason why you would even bring in the CEO thing is because of the assumption that that person might feel entitled. But in this case, it's the absolute reverse. The lady sitting in her seat and feels entitled to it. No. It doesn't matter what the title is then. No, you're the one acting entitled. And by the way, of course, I'm biased because I'm CEO of TYT. So this is a lot of nonsense here. But anyways, but I'll give you a perfect example of what all of this conversation has been about. So in that same international flight, I finally find a seat next to for my 9-year-old daughter that's kind of close to one of the parents, etc. And then the last seat is a disastrous middle seat near the back of the plane, and the two guys in the sides are gigantic, right?
Aww.
So if I go in there, we're gonna be like three guys in little jackets and whatever, okay?
So, guys in a little coat.
Yeah. So I look at Pro, my 11-year-old son, and I'm like, sorry, brother, you're batter up.
Yeah.
You're
character
going
building.
Yeah, character building and stuff. I'm like, here. And what you do, like JR said, you do trades, right? That's what humans do. And in this case, it's even with my own son. Like, I'm like, buy any of the movies you like. Okay, but off you go to the middle seat.
And a drink. Buy him a cocktail, Cenk. Why don't you be a good dad?
And by the way, Franny, you're also right about the empty middle seat. If I've got an empty middle seat next to me, it's like I won the lottery.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, yes. I'm like looking at the door the whole time. Please close the doors.
Go.
Yeah. And when they're like, all right, flight attendants, do the whatever thing that they say. And then they say like A and B or some code that they have, that means the doors are closed. I'm like, yes. Yeah.
If you look at the guys that are still filing onto the airplane, looking for their seat, and there's say 5 middle seats left, and there's 3 people walking on, the people in those seats with the middle seat available are watching like
100%.
Every time they sit down, like, okay.
Totally, totally.
There's one left.
JR's never said anything more true. Okay.
If you're that guy walking, people look at you so upset, like, you son of a bitch, you better not.
No, because seriously, all I care about is the width of the seat. Mm-hmm. So, like, when I was a cable news host and they had me flying business class, first class, etc., they're like, oh, warm nuts. I'm like, I don't give a damn about the nuts, okay? I just need a wide seat, okay? And so I feel like when there's no one in the middle, that I literally saved thousands of dollars, because to me, I just got a first class seat. I don't care about the food, I don't care about anything. I could fit. Whew. So that's worth thousands of dollars. And here comes
a
lady
like-
You think
there's someone out there who likes the middle? There's gotta be someone out there who's like, nah, I love the middle. I can have a conversation with this person who doesn't want to talk to me, and this person who doesn't want to talk to me. And but can we agree, if you're in the middle, you get both armrests, don't come at me. You get both of them.
Yes.
The middle armrests are yours.
Yes. I agree.
Okay, we could go on.
Yeah, if I don't know that you want to sit next to someone who wants the middle seat. There aren't a lot of good reasons for wanting the middle seat. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.